concept of virtual fence is quite simple. Manage livestock grazing without physical fences. Although it was first developed back in the 1980s, it is only recently that virtual fence has become practical to use on working ranches. Today, virtual fence is developing at a rapid pace, and there are a range of different systems available on the market. This series features early adopters of the technology from around the U.S. and uses their lived experience as a basis to provide viewers with a structured approach to adopting and using virtual fence.
I'm Pat Luark. I've been in this business for 64 years. My family's been here since 1924. I'm the fifth generation rancher on this land right here.
My name is Kristy Wallner. I'm a rangeland management specialist for the Colorado River Valley Field Office, which is a Bureau of Land Management.
The virtual fence come out 3 years ago, and Kristy Wallner brought it to my attention. And I was very interested. I didn't know much about it at the time, but it was $58 a year to put it on these cows with new technology. So we went to the HPP, Habitat Partnership Program. It is an organization where 5% of the revenue that's created by hunting license is donated to this for habitat projects.
So this idea started in 2020, and by the spring and April of 2021, we were implementing virtual fence. Pat was our first operator. We helped each other collar, and we actually put in the first base station together.
I went to the HPP to get that money. I couldn't afford that. Well, I could have, but I didn't think it was worthy of that. $58. Per cow, I didn't see the benefit. But looking back, if you look at the long term of what these do, and I hope you have some film on this that you've toured here of what we've been doing, of the grass we've created.
We called it the Field of Dreams. We were gonna build it and they'll come. The first six stations was a 350,000 acre virtual fence network. We're in partnership with the Forest Service, Eagle County Conservation District, and us. We're wiring the Roaring Fork right now, and Capitol Peak is gonna be the first Colorado 14er that's gonna be managed under virtual fence with 500 head. We're almost completing that last network, and we'll be at 610,000 acres. And our goal is to be at 1 million acres in our entire office virtually fenced for anybody to use as a public service.
And I see my neighbors doing the same thing. We just come back from Pisgah, which has been overgrazed like I used to overgraze for years. And it had a couple years rest because of fence collars. It is absolutely beautiful. And it's exciting. It's exciting to see that.
Your goal is rest, rotation, and recovery. And using your tools of timing, intensity, duration, and frequency.
It feels good to be involved in some of that. The evolution, we'll call it, of grazing. The complexity, the what we've learned, how to do it. If you're not willing to do all this, you're going to be disappointed. But if you're willing to put some time in on it, it's going to create more grass than you've ever seen in your life. Mother Nature is one quick response. It can heal as quick as us producers have overused it.
Public land grazing is under fire. It is absolutely under fire. And so your incentive to raise grass is how we stay united.
The grass that we've created by rest rotation is absolutely, unequivocally, the finest thing that ever hit my life.
Besides the rest rotation, that's our number one value, I'd say. But if you think about how busy our public lands are getting with recreation and gates, We can have the best management and the best fences, but if one mountain biker or one side-by-side goes through and leaves a gate down, you lose your entire herd. In the past, we have a lot of interior fences that the government funded, and for numerous reasons, those hard fences are dilapidated all over public ground. A, we don't have the labor or the dollars to restore them. And the virtual fence gives us an option again for interior pasture fences without anything permanent.
Now, I want to bring up one more thing. The NRCS has doing a lot of cost share now with this. So we're getting basically free collars for doing what they kind of want us to do, which is the correct way. So it's another government agency getting involved. The BLM, it's a team, and we're gaining big time.
The BLM is providing the infrastructure, just like hard wire, fence posts, cattle guards. The base stations provide the virtual fence for the operator to plug into. We have nothing to do with the monitoring or tracking of the collar data. I think the appropriate use of the data is a discussion that happens between your permittee and your range specialist and how it applies to the management of the permit. And anything that they want to share, that could be shared and put into the grazing file, just like a compliance report, or just like a map of utilization, or anything else we might put in a grazing file to use to inform the permitting process.
Your question was, how has it been to work with the BLM of our virtual fence? That's very simple. It's a learning curve for both of us. And we are changing with the winds every day. We bounce stuff off of each other all the time. What's gonna happen if we do this? What about this? The next day, it got a whole different plan. That is the best thing about virtual fence, is the adaptivity of the mind. I mean, it can do whatever.
As a range con, you need to stay around and learn ground and hear producer stories and learn from them. You didn't learn it all in a school book. These guys know. They're awesome. They're our partners.
Well,
and he's invested in me.
there's one thing I'll bring up, because I can spew anything because you can move it around. But in 1924, my grandma moved into this country. And they talked to old ranchers who had been here. And they said that the grass was stirrup high to their horses, waving. That's how we have abused this ground. And we see that is achievable to get that back. And what's really amazing is Mother Nature is so resilient. And one of the reasons she's a little expedient on that is the tools, like Kristy brought up. The virtual fence collar is a big plus to that, as well as some chemical spraying, chopping trees. It's everything. But we got knowledge now, and we got capability of sharing knowledge to expedite this process. It's a great time to be alive. And we got all these people against grazing. We got a lot of people for it. I hope whoever wins actually does the winning for the land, for
an agenda.
Their agenda, yes.
That the land wins.
Yeah, very good. I hope the land wins. Good job. So how far does it go down, this picture?
Yeah, we'll put that in. That'll be in the bloopers.